Stories, is that mince and tatties?
No, this is what we were talking about. I saw your re-mention last night, and I thought Kareem might not have had this. What it is, the Scottish, because there were so many people in families, big families, and there wasn't a lot of money to go around, you had to get the food right.
Okay.
And the way to get the food right was you usually had a kind of set menu over the week. So you had things like maybe Saturday night was a bit of a splash out with pie, beans and chips or something. And then on your Sunday, if you had a joint of beef for a ham hock, you made your soup. You got a bone for soup. Very often the butcher would just give you a bone. And you boiled and boiled and boiled that bone. And then you added all your barley and your vegetables and everything. And you had a big pot of broth to feed the wains. So that was a good starter there. Then you had your beef and your potatoes and everything. Then on your Monday, you could have cold beef, a wee bit brisket or silver side or something like that. And then anything left, you could chop it up. And you fried it up with onions and beef dripping and mashed potatoes. And that made you your stovies. So everybody got a huge, big spoonful of something. So it was very good. Somebody saying tatties, a wee bit onion and carrot, and a square sausage. Perfection. So there you are. So it's fair all coming out now. Do you know what I mean?
It sounds as if it definitely filled you up.
Well, people used to be very so proud in Scotland. They were very proud that we were never poor. How dare you insinuate? But, you know, money was tight. But the food was all fresh because instead of being flown round the world, you went to the butcher.
And the
butcher had the shop and he had beasts hanging up in the shop and he actually gave you your cuts of meat off the beast.
Yeah. Do you know, it's a shame, Scotty, because I remember when I was, about 6 or 7, I was brought up briefly down at Pollock Shaw's in Glasgow, if you know the area.
Uh-huh.
And there was a local butcher's, and it was a huge butcher's. And I actually think they had some animals in the back sometimes, the way they were. But it's now closed down, and it's just like a wee office.
Right.
And I think that's happened over the years with so many butchers.
Well, this is it. You see, all this so-called health and safety and so-called hygiene, I mean, we used to lean on the beasts and have a chat.
Uh-huh.
With your jacket on, you know, it's incredible. And then the butcher would give you your meat and he would wrap it just in a brown paper parcel, you know.
Yeah. But I'll tell you...